Hello friends, hope you are all safe. Okay, in this video a frame element is considered and its local stiffness matrix KL, rotational transformation matrix T and global stiffness matrix KG are going to be derived. First let us derive the local stiffness matrix KL for a frame element. For that consider a frame element of length L. In a frame element, three forces will be acting in a member, that is, there will be three member forces, which are one axial force, one shear force and one moment, that is, three member forces will be acting in a member. Similarly, there will be three displacement, that is, one in x direction, one displacement in y direction and one rotation in z direction. Okay. Here in member 1, 2, let at node 1 the three forces be P1, P2 and P3. That is, P1 is the axial force, P2 is the shear force and P3 is the moment. Similarly, at node 2 let the forces be P4, P5 and P6. Similarly, displacement at node 1 be D1, D2 and D3 and at node 2 be D4, D5 and D6. Okay. Now we have a relation K is equal to P into delta, where K is the stiffness, P is the member force and delta is the displacement. If delta is equal to unity or equal to 1, then stiffness K will be equal to the member force. That is, if we consider displacement equal to 1, then the force acting in the member will be equal to the stiffness of the member. Using the relation, let us derive the local stiffness matrix KL for this frame element. D1 is the displacement occurring at node 1. Assume that only D1 is occurring at node 1, that is, all other 5 displacements are arrested. Now for the displacement D1 to occur, let the force acting be P1 at node 1. P1 will be acting rightwards, that is, towards a positive x direction. For the equilibrium of the member, an equal and opposite force will be acting at node 2. Let it be P4. Since we are taking axial displacements as D1 and D4, we have named the axial forces as P1 and P4. Okay. Now we have a relation. Young's modulus E is equal to stress by strain, where stress is force by area, that is P by A, and strain is change in length by original length, that is delta L by L. Therefore, rearranging this equation, we get E is equal to PL by A delta L. From this, delta L is equal to PL by AE. Okay. Here, displacement delta L equal to D1 equal to 1. Equating this in the above equation, we will get 1 equal to PL by AE and from this, P is equal to AE by L. That is, member force P is equal to AE by L. P1 is acting towards positive x direction, therefore P1 equal to AE by L, while P4 is acting in the negative x direction, therefore P4 equal to minus AE by L. Now when displacement is equal to 1, then stiffness will be equal to the member force. Therefore, local stiffness KL1 will be equal to P1, which equal to AE by L for D1 equal to 1 and KL2 equal to P4, which is equal to minus AE by L for D1 equal to 1. Writing it in matrix form, KL local stiffness matrix KL is equal to AE by L 0 0 minus AE by L 0 0 for D1 equal to 1. Similarly, we can fill the other terms in the matrices for other displacement, that is equating other displacement to 1. Next, consider D2 equal to 1. D2 is the displacement at node 1 in y direction. It can also be considered as sinking of support 1 in positive y direction. By sinking of supports, the moments formed are 6EI by L square and the reaction support reactions formed are 12EI by L cube. Now let us see its derivation. For N moments, consider the slope deflection equation, which is MAB equal to M of AB plus 2EI by L into 2 theta A plus theta B minus 3 delta by L, where 3 delta by L is for sinking of supports. Okay, so moment due to sinking of supports is 2EI by L into minus 3 delta by L, which is equal to minus 6EI delta by L square, where negative implies clockwise moment. Therefore, here sinking of support it is in anti-clockwise direction, so moment will be 6EI delta by L square. Okay, next is end forces. We know that moment equal to force into distance. Therefore, force equal to moment divided by distance. Here moments are 6EI delta by L square on left end, that is at node 1, plus 6EI delta by L square at node 2, divided by the length of the member, which is L. Therefore, total the force will be 12EI delta by L cube. But here we have considered displacement delta equal to D2 equal to unity, that is 1. Therefore, moment M equal to 6EI by L square and force is equal to 12EI by L cube. Okay, this is how we have obtained the end moments and end forces. So now we can complete the stiffness matrix for D2 equal to 1, which is 0, 12EI by L cube, 6EI by L square, 0, minus 12EI by L cube and 6EI by L square. Okay. Next is displacement D3 equal to 1. D3 is the rotation in Z direction at node 1. Therefore, when a rotation acts in a member, the near end moment will be 4EI by L and the far end moment will be 2EI by L when the far end is fixed. Similarly, the near end force will be 6EI by L square and the far end force will be 6EI by L square. Now to derive these moments, you can again consider the slope deflection equation, which is MAB equal to M of AB plus 2EI by L into 2 theta A plus theta B minus 3 delta by L, where theta A is the near end rotation and theta B is the far end rotation. Okay, so moment due to near end rotation will be 2EI by L into 2 theta A, that is 4EI by L into theta A, and moment at far end will be 2EI by L into theta B, which is 2EI theta B by L. Okay, here theta A and theta B are displacement, that is D3 or rotation D3, which is equated to 1. Therefore, moment will be, near end moment will be 4EI by L and far end moment will be 2EI by L. Now to get the end forces, moment equal to force into distance, therefore force equal to moment by distance. Both moments are in anti-clockwise direction, therefore force is equal to 4EI by L plus 2EI by L divided by L, which is 6EI by L square. Okay, therefore moments are MA equal to minus 4EI by L and MB is equal to minus 2EI by L and force is 6EI by L square. Now we can write these as elements in the local stiffness matrix for D3 equal to 1, which is 0, 6EI by L square, 4ei by L 0 minus 6ei by L square and 2ei by L. Okay. Now at node 2, the displacements are d4, d5 and d6. Stiffness due to these displacement will have the same values as that of d1, d2 and d3, but in an opposite direction. But their direction will be reversed or opposite to that of d1, d2 and d3, but they will have the same values. That is, for d4 equal to 1, p1 will be minus ae by l and p4 will be positive ae by l. Next, for d5 equal to 1, moments will be 6ei by l square in clockwise direction, that is sign will be negative. And the left hand at node 1, the force is 12ei by l cube downwards, that is minus 12ei by l cube, and at node 2 the force will be positive 12ei by l cube. Finally, for d6 equal to 1, at node 2 the near end moment will be 4ei by l, and at far end, that is at node 1, the moment will be 2ei by l, and the forces are 6ei by l square. Now we can complete the local stiffness matrix for these 6 displacement. So the local stiffness matrix KL will be equal to, which is for d1 equal to 1, ae by l 0 0 minus ae by l 0 0. For d2 equal to 1, 0 12ei by l cube 6ei by l square 0 minus 12ei by l cube 6ei by l square. For d3 equal to 1, 0 6ei by l square 4ei by l 0 minus 6ei by l square and 2ei by l. For d4 equal to 1, it will be minus ae by l 0 0 ae by l 0 0. For d5 equal to 1, it will be 0 minus 12ei by l cube minus 6ei by l square 0 12ei by l cube and minus 6ei by l square. And finally, for d6 equal to 1, 0 6ei by l square 2ei by l 0 minus 6ei by l square and 4ei by l. Okay. In most of the frame designs, the axial elongation of the members are neglected. That is, if axial deformation of the members are neglected, here D1 and D4 are the axial deformations or axial displacement. If they are neglected, then the stiffness matrix, our local stiffness matrix becomes, that is, D1 row and column are deleted and D4 row and column are deleted. Then local stiffness matrix KL is equal to 12ei by L cube 6ei by L square minus 12ei by L cube 6ei by L square 6ei by L square 4ei by L minus 6ei by L square 2ei by L minus 12ei by L cube minus 6ei by L square 12ei by l cube minus 6ei by l square 6ei by l square 2ei by l minus 6ei by l square and 4ei by l. Okay. Next is the transformation matrix for a frame element, that is T. Transformation matrix is used to convert local coordinates to global coordinates and vice versa. Here you can see there are 6 local displacements, that is at node 1, d1, d2 and d3. d1 in x direction, d2 in y direction and d3 in z direction. Similarly, at node 2, 3 displacements are d4, d5 and d6. Okay, let us first consider the displacements d1 and d4, that is axial displacements d1 and d4. In local coordinates, we can simply say that point A has moved d1 distance in local x direction to reach point B. But in global coordinate system, what we have to say is point A has moved capital D1 distance in global x direction and then capital D2 distance in global y direction. That is, capital D1 and D2 are the global counterparts of local D1. The distances small d1, capital D1 and capital D2 form a right angle triangle AOB, right angle at O. Angle A equal to theta, which is the inclination of the member with respect to global x-axis. If angle A equal to theta, then in the right triangle AOB, angle B will be equal to 90 minus theta. Next, dropping a perpendicular OC from O to side AB, point C divides side AB into two lengths, into two, that is AC and CB. Let their length be D1A and D1B, that is AC equal to D1A and CB is equal to D1B. And we already know that the total length AB is D1, small d1. Now in triangle OCA, cos theta is equal to D1A divided by capital D1. Therefore, D1A, small d1A is equal to capital D1 cos theta. Let it be our first equation. Now in the next triangle, right angle triangle OCB, cos 90 minus theta is equal to small d1b divided by capital D2. Therefore, small d1b is equal to capital D2 into cos 90 minus theta. Let it be our second equation. Adding equation 1 and 2, we get small d1a plus small d1b is equal to capital D1 cos theta plus capital D2 cos 90 minus theta. But we have small d1a plus d1b is the total length of AB, that is small d1. And we know that cos 90 minus theta is sine theta. So substituting this in this equation, we will get small d1 equal to capital D1 cos theta plus capital D2 sin theta. That is, local distance D1 is equal to global distance D1 cos theta plus global D2 sin theta. Similarly, for the displacement at node 2, D4 is equal to capital D4 cos theta plus capital D5 sin theta. Okay. Now consider the displacements D2 and D5, which are the displacements in y direction, that is local displacements in y direction. Displacements small d1, small d2 and capital D2 forms the sides of a right angle triangle AOB, right angle at O. The inclination of the member with respect to global x-axis is theta. Therefore, angle A, that is angle BAO, will be 90 minus theta. So, in the triangle AOB, in the right angle triangle AOB, angle B will be theta. Length BC is D2A and length ACB D2B. Now consider the triangle OCB. OCB, right angle at C. In this triangle, cos theta is equal to D2A, capital D2A divided by small d2. Therefore, capital D2A is equal to small d2 cos theta. Let it be our first equation. And in triangle OCA, cos 90 minus theta is equal to sin theta, which is equal to D2B, capital D2B divided by small d1. Therefore, capital D2B is equal to small d1 into sin theta. Let it be our second equation. Adding 1 and 2, we get capital D2A plus capital D2B is equal to small d2 cos theta plus small d1 sin theta. That is, capital D2A plus D2B is capital D2. That is the total length D2. And we have already derived that small d1 is equal to capital D1 cos theta plus capital D2 sin theta. So substituting these in the equation, we get capital D2 is equal to small d2 cos theta plus capital D1 cos theta plus capital D2 sin theta whole into sin theta. That is, capital D2 is equal to small d2 cos theta plus capital D1 cos theta sin theta plus capital D2 sin square theta. Taking D2 to one side and small d2 to one side and capital D2 other side, we get small d2 cos theta is equal to capital D2 minus D2 sin square theta minus capital D1 cos theta sin theta. Okay, now grouping the capital D2 terms, we get small d2 cos theta is equal to capital D2 into 1 minus sin square theta minus capital D1 cos theta sin theta. We know that 1 minus sin square theta is equal to cos square theta. So substituting this, we get small d2 cos theta is equal to capital D2 cos square theta minus capital D1 cos theta sin theta. Now cancelling cos theta from all sides, we get small d2 is equal to capital D2 cos theta minus capital D1 sin theta. Rearranging this equation, we get small d2 is equal to minus capital D1 sin theta plus capital D2 cos theta. Similarly, for the displacement at node 2 in y direction, that is d5, can be written as d5 is equal to minus capital D4 sin theta plus d5 cos theta. Okay, next is the displacement in z direction or rotation in z direction, that is d3 and d6. The local and global rotation will be same, that is small d3 is equal to capital d3 and small d6 will be equal to capital d6. Finally, writing all local displacements in terms of global coordinates, we get small d1 is equal to capital d1 cos theta plus capital d2 sin theta. Small d2 equal to minus capital d1 sin theta plus capital d2 cos theta. Small d3 is equal to capital d3. Similarly, small d4 is equal to capital d4 cos theta plus capital d5 sin theta. Small d5 is equal to minus d4 sin theta plus d5 cos theta, and small d6 equal to capital d6. Now writing this in matrix form and representing c for cos theta and s for sin theta, we get local displacement matrix small d1, d2, d3, d4, d5 and d6 is equal to CS0 0 0 0 minus SC0 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 0 0 CS0 0 0 0 minus SC0 0 0 0 0 0 1 into global displacement, that is capital D1, D2, D3, D4, D5 and D6. The matrix connecting the local displacement small d and global displacement capital D is called the rotational transformation matrix T, that is small d is equal to T into capital D. To easily remember the transformation matrix T, we can divide it into four parts. The first part consists of CS0 minus SC0 0 0 1. The second and third part are null matrix, that is 0 matrix And the fourth part, again it is similar to first part, that is S0 minus SC0 and 001. So for to easily remember the transformation matrix T, it can be written as matrix of R00R, where R is CS0 minus SC0 and 001, where C is cos theta and S is sin theta. Okay. Next is global stiffness matrix Kg for a frame element. We have a relation Kg is equal to T transpose KL into T, where T is transformation matrix and KL is the local stiffness matrix. So we have already derived the local stiffness matrix KL and transformation matrix T. Substituting T transpose or equating T transpose KL T equal to Kg, we will get the global transformation matrix Kg. After multiplication, we get Kg, that is global stiffness matrix Kg, as a 6x6 symmetric matrix. Since it is difficult to memorize this matrix, it is better to calculate by multiplying T transpose KL into T. Okay. And also almost all beam elements are parallel to both local and global x-axis. That is, inclination of the member theta will be 0. Then transformation matrix will become an identity matrix. Okay. In such cases, global stiffness matrix Kg will be equal to the local stiffness matrix KL. That is, Kg matrix is derived only when the member is inclined with respect to the global x-axis. Okay. So in this video, we have derived the local stiffness matrix, transformation matrix, and global stiffness matrix for a frame element. Okay, thank you. Thank you for watching.